Now let's come to the point. Whenever there is a disaster, we have to be prepared with our whole team, and whole team has to be have a supporting team, supporting sub teams, and every sub team has a task force. So let's see which are the task force, which are the important sub teams which are actively involved in preparing for the disaster as well as managing the disaster effectively. The very first and important team which plays a very important role, that is awareness team. The team which is involved in executing the awareness trainings, awareness camps, awareness some kind of communication. So that team is responsible for all these activities. Second team is very important, as this team is responsible for evacuation at the time of disaster. So second team is evacuation team, and it has all the resources, it has all the techniques to be followed at the time of disaster and to have a perfect evacuation within stipulated time as soon as the disaster hit to your education institute. Third very important team is a search and rescue team. After the evacuation team has played its role, but still there are some students, there are some faculty, there are some staff members, there are some weak students which may be lying overall, lying nearby the institute. So that particular students has to be rescued, those students has to be searched for, whether they are trapped inside the disaster or whether they are prone to be victim of the disaster. That particular team is responsible for searching and rescuing the people who are trapped inside. Next important team is a fire safety team. This team is responsible for if any fire incidents took place, then we have to extinguish that fire with the help of people from the outside agency or from the within institute's resources. Next and very important team is a first aid team. If at the time of evacuation some students or some faculties, some teachers are get injured, so that time this first aid team is playing very important role, because whenever the evacuation took place, most of the students, most of the teachers are involved with the panic attack. Because of the fear, these people are in a panic condition, and that time some mistakes could happen which are going to be fatal as well as having some injuries, and that injury is leading to some wound or a blood flow. So that time first aid is very important. In the city areas, the bus, which the school bus or the institute's traveling mechanism is also playing a very important role for evacuating the students, evacuating the staff members to their respective home, to their respective place. Is that the transportation mechanism also has some involvement in disaster preparedness, and for that purpose we have a separate sub team for institute bus or transport disaster management committee. And very important, every institute is nowadays having its own security force for allowing the people to come inside the institute or stopping the person going away or running out of the institute with some thing. As a security point of view, the security team has to be involved for training, evacuation and supporting team as a disaster management committee. So site security team is very important, which involves the security of the premises as well as the security persons who are actively involved in the institute's entry gates, and plays very important role for site security disaster management team. Now only making a committee, only making a team is not going to help that institute for making a disaster preparedness. So for that purpose, the institute required some resources, some physical resources, which are going to play an important role for dealing with the disaster. And which are those resources? So very first task we have to do is making a list of the resources required after the disaster could have took place. Disaster response is again a very important term. So how you are going to respond to that disaster requires some resources, and those resources has to we brought into the institute has to kept in a stores, kept in a disaster preparedness institute area. So the resources which are required are generally the food supplies as well as the medical equipments or medical materials and the logistics. Also, we required the all contact details of nearby hospitals, nearby police station, nearby fire agencies. So these all resources plays a very important role. Also, we required the updated telephone numbers of the students, their parents, and a communication system by which we are going to communicate with the parents at the time of disaster. It is also very important resource that we should have a data of the students which are having some critical medical condition. Also, in a disaster preparedness plan, we are making a checklist before the disaster. So that checklist has to be available with every disaster management committee member to check whether we are ready for that disaster response or whether we have some resources required for having the response. Just visit our website and you will get how to make a disaster preparedness checklist. Similarly, the institute should have the disaster management kit ready for the institute. The disaster management committee has to look after how to handle, how to get the disaster management kit in the institute and how to prevent and how to update that over the time. Because disaster management kit is not going to help you be used when there is no disaster. But if there is a disaster, the disaster management kit plays very important role. And what are the things which are involved in disaster management kit are a stretcher, ladders, a thick rope, torch and a first aid box, temporary shelters, sand buckets or fire extinguishers, and as well as the well maintained fire extinguishers.
ये YouTube चैनल पे आप सभी का स्वागत है। अगर आप यहाँ पे पहली बार आए हो, तो हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और हमारे सभी वीडियोस को पहली बार पाने के लिए बेल आइकॉन को हिट कीजिए।